Some books you race through and wish they were twice as long, even when they're 700 pages, like Harry Potter. Some books you read slow and steady, but even if they're less than 200 pages, like The Ocean at the End of the Lane, they feel long enough. And some books you read in furious but short spurts, because you know that you're going to be sad when it's over, but you can't help reading as fast as possible. The Magician King is such a book. Any pacing issues or plot not startingness that plagued the first book are gone in the second one. There's still a fair amount of growing up, becoming an adult angst, but even that was less grating since Quentin actually seemed to learn something in the end. Lev Grossman is excellent at weaving together traditions and ritual and mythology and literature into something wonderful. Quentin misses his quest, with disastrous consequences for him. But he is later able to find his predestined story, the titular Magician King. One of my favorite lines is when Quentin meets the guardian of the thing he's seeking. He was part of the fairy tale now, he supposed. He crashed through a shared wall into an adjoining story. Enter the Magician King. It's like when Indiana Jones meets the guardian of the Holy Grail. The mythologies aren't supposed to mix like that. But here they do, and it just works. They bring folk magic and comparative religion into it too, as well as the merits of institutional versus real-world street education. This book has everything from dryads and dragons to message boards and hackers, both of computers and of something more fundamental. I won't say any more than that, only that you should get through The Magicians if only to read The Magician King. And I am definitely looking forward to the next book. That is the problem with starting a series before it's been completed. You have to wait for the next book.